One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Hey everybody, and welcome back to Swift Guitar Lessons for another Lick of the Week tutorial. In today's session, I'm going to be breaking down a lick from Stephane Wrembel. This is going to be from his Midnight in Paris theme, Bistro Fada. Now, in doing so, I'm also going to be breaking down one of the ways in which I hone my lead guitar skills. Basically, I listen to a tune and wait for something to catch my ear. Once I have a lick that I'm interested in learning, I analyze it in a few different ways. First, I learn the lick, then I take a look at which chords are being performed underneath of that lick. That way, I'm getting the musical context. Now the next thing that I do is I look at all the different notes inside the lick as raw materials. I ask myself, within that position, do I recognize any scales and arpeggios? Those are a couple of the ideas that we're going to employ as we go through this lesson. Now let's get started with a full breakdown. Okay, welcome to section one of this lesson. Here we're going to be analyzing the backing track. Which chords was I playing over top of? Well, starting off the demonstration, I began with E minor to A minor in three-quarter time. Then I moved to two more appropriate chords right out of the original track, E7 flat 9 and A minor 6. So our first variety sounded something like this. Very, very simple. Start off with that very cool walk down. 2, 3, 2. Open A string. G on the 3rd fret. F sharp on the 2nd fret, low E string. And then the open E string. That gets us to an E minor chord. We already hit the root. And then we strum through the high strings, D string down to high E string, twice. That's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Then we're gonna do the same thing on A minor. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And you can bounce back and forth between those two chords, and that's a very good backing track to use for practicing this lick. All right, then I switched to the chords that were actually performed in the original track. That was E, 7 flat 9 to A minor 6. Okay, so let's learn these chords. This is some pretty fancy stuff. So we have the middle finger on the 7th fret of the A string. We have the major 3rd, that's the 6th fret of the D string. And the flat at 7 here on the 7th fret of the G string. The index finger is barring, so that way you can get the flat at 9 note. This is a note that's going to be featured later in the lick, okay, and for good reason. So that's going to be the 6th fret of the B string. So there's our chord tones for that E7 flat 9 chord. Okay, so we'll have the low E string, and then that same rhythm that we had before for E minor. All right, then we have another chord that we need to learn. The A minor 6 chord. 5 on the low E string, 4 on the D string, then my ring finger and my pinky on the 5th frets of the G string and the B string. Alright, that's that minor swing chord. Okay, so these are two very, very common Gypsy Jazz chords. The E7 flat 9 to the A minor 6 chord. Okay, great work everybody. Now you have an idea of what was being performed underneath of that lick of the week. Now we're moving into section 2 of this lesson where we're going to analyze useful scales and arpeggios. These are the scales that I suspect Stephane was visualizing when he was putting together this melody line. Okay, so when I play that lick of the week, I can visualize a couple of scales and at least one arpeggio being employed there. The first of which is the E natural minor scale. Something very good for jamming over top of chord progressions in E minor. Looks and sounds like this. Okay, so that was the A string 7 with the pinky, D string 4, 5, 7. Same thing on the G string. Then the B string, we have 5, 7, 8. 5, 7, 8. Okay, so that is definitely a scale that you want to have down for jamming over top of. E minor. Now, the next scale that jumped right out at me was the A harmonic minor scale. This is where he's picking up some of that Eastern kind of flavor. Okay, so our A harmonic minor scale is gonna look and sound like this. That's the first octave, then. The second octave. So E string, 5, 7, 8. Same thing on the A string. Then 6, 7 on the D string to complete an octave. All right, then onto the G string, we're going to have 4, 5, 7. The B string, 5, 6. High E string, 4, 5, 7, 8. I'm sure you can recognize some of the notes from our lick inside of that scale, okay, once you've got the lick down. Okay, so once again, 5, 7, 8, 5, 7, 8, 6, 7, 4, 5, 7, 5, 6, 4, 5 to finish the second octave, and then 7, 8 belonging to the third octave. Okay, and one final ingredient that I see at work here is an E7 flat 9 arpeggio. It's built into this lick, and it makes sense because he's playing over top of E7 flat 9, and he's resolving down to A minor. So this E7 flat 9 arpeggio, very slow, is gonna look and sound like this. Very interesting. Okay, really cool sound. 7th fret on the A string, 6th fret on the D string, so that's the root of the E, the major third. All right, then we're on to the 4th fret of the G string. That's the 5th inside of an E chord. Okay, so it's making sense. All right, then we're gonna have the dominant 7. All right, that flat 7 here on the 7th fret of the G string. So far you have root, major 3rd, 5th, dominant 7. Then the ring finger to the flat 9, 6th fret of the B string. And then we're on to the high E string, playing the major third again. This is going to be the 4th fret of the high E string before reaching out to the 7th fret of the high E. All right, that's a 4 arpeggio right there. All right, that takes a little bit of practice. You can practice going all downstrokes unless you have more than one note on a single string, then you would throw in an upstroke. Okay, great work everybody. Thus far we've studied our backing track, picked up a couple of very useful common Gypsy Jazz chord shapes, and we also studied the scales and arpeggios that I recognized inside of this very, very cool melodic lick. If you study those things, then you will also be able to see the connection between those musical elements and the notes inside the phrase. Now, let's take a look at the lick of the week. Okay, so once again, our lick of the week, you can follow along using the tablature at patreon.com/swiftlessons. It's gonna sound like this real slow. Okay, just a tiny bit simplified from what is on the original track. Okay, and at full speed. Okay, so let's break that up into three different parts. Part number one's gonna sound like this. Very, very common Gypsy Jazz move. So we're going to play 5th fret of the B string, 6 pulling back to 5, and sliding down to 4, back up to 5, 6, 5. Real slow. All right, then the second section is gonna sound like this. Seventh fret on the high E string, 4, 6, 5. Then we're going to 7-5 on the G string. All right, you put part one and part two together, we have. Then finally we have section three of this lick. G string, four, hammering up to five, and then pulling back down to four. D string seven, six, seven, and vibrato. Okay, I might use my ring finger and my middle finger for that section. Put all that together, we have section one, two, three, for the lick of the week. All right, everyone, thanks so much for checking out this lick of the week. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks so much to my patrons at patreon.com/swiftlessons. Hope you're enjoying the extra resources. I got many more videos coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe and please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.